Yeah. Ah, it's 13, okay. Okay, greetings from Venice. Many happy returns. The WBGF World Individual Championship. Live in the studio, we have my good self, Eric McAlpine from the UK. From Bulgaria and Italy, we have Bojo and Gianlazzaro. Hi, guys.
Hello, Eric. Hello, everyone.
This is the final of the undefeated bracket. Jörgen Grandsted from Sweden versus Reece Hodges from the UK. Okay, I can see they've already started. And without any further delay, I would like to invite into the studio our special guest from Japan, Grandmaster Michihito Kageyama. Hi, Michi. Okay, I don't think he's live in the studio just yet, but he'll be along very, very soon. Okay, so this is the first game, first to 13 points. Who's going to earn their right for a place in the final and the possibility to be world individual champion? The young gun, Reece Hodges from the United Kingdom versus triple world champion, Jörgen Grandsted. Aha, and here's the first decision. The cube, yeah. What do you think, Bojo?
It's an interesting decision. Yeah, I like it. It looks like a take. And just to say that Jörgen is playing at the bottom, and Reece is playing on the top. So we are working on changing the positions of the players in the image. But we got the drop, so it's 1-0, Jörgen.
It is indeed. And maybe this is the lucky seat for the triple world champion. Not saying that he's superstitious, but I know the kind of feeling when you're playing in tournaments and you're on a roll. You like to, if you're playing on the main board or a board you've played on before, if you've won there, you more often than not, we'll take that same side again and hope to replicate the feeling. Okay, yeah.
Hits. Well, last night Jörgen was sitting on the other side of the board, so I don't think this makes any difference to him.
I agree.
He's a triple world champion, so those kind of super strong players, they can play under any circumstances and they can win at any time, any match.
Oh, no doubt about that. I'm just more referencing because the previous round he had a delightful match against Elias Kritikos from Norway. So he was successful. So it's a little bit of McAlpine kidology here. Okay, yeah. Nestles up to the 20, down to the 11. Double twos, lovely shake. One, 2-1. And yeah, lovely shake. Makes the 5 point. Nice solid 4 prime. Okay. This is going to be a shot. And now it's just a case of how does he see it? What do you think here, Bojo? I see two or three different plays here.
Let me see. Did he play already something?
He hasn't played anything thus far.
Okay, this is one of those very annoying 4-5 in the beginning of the game. Well, let's see. Yeah, probably going to the 4 point from the mid or mid to eight and slotting the deuce. I don't think it would be good for him lose hit on the ace and leaving one more blot. So I guess two blots in now.
I agree with you. Yeah.
To consider slotting the deuce. Looks like the safest play.
It's definitely the safest, but is it the most effective? Is it the most effective?
So.
I'm slightly may prefer slotting the four here, just because it's a more powerful point to make if you do get missed here. A bit more gain in the position. Yes, a few more shots, but I think it's worth the risk as he's so powerful on the other side. Okay, prefers the minimum shots. No harm done. And 42. Buckle my shoe. Yeah, hitting down.
Okay, once again to remind that Jörgen is playing on the bottom and Reece is playing on the top. So the image the viewers are seeing on YouTube is still wrong. We are working on replacing it and fixing the positions.
Hi, yes. Hi, Eric.
Ah, welcome, Michi. How
Yeah, I'm great. Yeah.
Ah, good.
Welcome to the studio, Michi.
Yeah, welcome.
Wow.
Very happy to have you join us.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Oh, it's very much our pleasure to have someone with your wonderful insight and distinctive style.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. So now the score is 1-0.
1-0, yeah. 1-0 to Jörgen. This is the second game. Even though it's my countryman playing, this is the first time I've had the privilege to see him play backgammon.
Mm-hmm.
He did represent the UK team, so he's obviously made it the right stuff.
Michi, just to be aware, Jörgen is playing on the bottom with red checkers.
Oh,
and
Reece really?
Is playing on the top with white, so we are working on changing the directions of the image.
Okay, now I get it. Okay, Jörgen is on the bottom.
He is. Okay, so 4-3, yeah. Yeah, okay. Some nice contact here, hoping for a reasonable exchange. Okay, he's going to have to take some action here. And now, what do you think? Anchor or hit? I like this one.
Yeah. Anchoring is mandatory. Otherwise, red might double.
Yes, very good point, Michi. And also, as he has, or he did have 3.5 men back, even more important to anchor up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now, red is far away from doubling.
Yes, very much so. Puts a stopper in the tracks. Doesn't allow him to go for the blitz. Yeah, I can't quite, yeah. Okay. Just having a little look.
Okay, so we have the correct positions of the two players already. Thanks everybody for the patience.
Indeed. And now it's turning into a much more interesting game. Okay. He does have a few options here. He can do this and then make it, or he can jump up to the 20, only leaving it. And there's also this. I will take a little more risk here, as he's still got the exposed block on the 4 point. I prefer one of the other ways, personally. Just because you may have the chance, three down, you might make a five prime this way.
Yeah. Okay, now white has four shots.
He does. And no good. So, okay. Let's see what he does here.
Yeah, this 3-2 is a headache.
Big headache, but I like the way he's thinking. Powering up the board. I think the other way, if he doesn't want to leave anything, would be 6 point and ace point, but it's going to be very difficult to win the game that way.
Okay, you like it? No, it's not my play.
Yeah, I like it because he's so strong on the other side, and yes, you're leaving a direct six and also a nine, but if you get missed, you're much better off in the position.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, now white has a smooth position. Yeah, but I would choose a safe play if I were white.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and is that because of the force and power of Jörgen's position being so powerful?
6-5. Wow!
Wow, oh yes. Bam, he hits.
It's a great shot.
It's a fantastic shot.
Oh my
nice
goodness.
Joker.
Oh, and there's the fan. Still more work to do. Yeah. Oh, this is reasonable. Yeah.
Going
just
to
got
the 4 point. Yeah.
Looks good. And?
Oh,
and
this is...
he is in.
Yeah. He's in and out in the best position, I feel. Ready to cover the straggler.
Yep, nice outfield control.
Absolutely, yeah.
Again, 4-3, not allowing him to jump over the prime.
Yeah.
Now, let's start thinking about the doubling.
Yeah, I think, okay, prefers to roll. This is going to be a hit for sure. And yeah. Has coverage.
So what's going to happen if white dances?
Well, for sure, the cube is going to fly. Okay, that didn't happen. He comes in hitting. Bam!
Yeah, and the four is okay.
Yeah, nothing better to do, in the great words of the legendary falafel.
Wow! Eric, you knew that.
Oh, how could you ever forget one of the greatest commentators ever? Yes, that's one of his legendary sayings. Yes, I always remember.
Ooh, okay, it's a comfortable dice. So
it is.
Come out and hit.
Yes, you must. You must protect yourself here. Hope for the dance.
Ooh.
Jörgen, there it is.
Okay.
Jörgen happy that he didn't double two rolls ago.
Yeah, for sure. And this must be a cube.
That's correct. So I think the game is over.
I agree with you.
I agree.
Yeah, too powerful in the forward position. Too many gammons, too many hits. Too difficult to win or counter or turn around. So yes, one apiece. First to 13.
Yep. Now the score is 12-12.
Indeedy. Okay. Game on.
53. Makes the three.
Yes.
Down and split.
Six and two. Yeah, hitting on.
Okay, nice anchor for you.
Yep.
Beautiful anchor. That's always the way you like it when you're under pressure. Okay, there's the five. Yeah.
No slotting on the 5 point?
Not quite yet. But I'm sure we'll see some action there soon. Yeah. Just
maybe we will see slotting now to the bar.
Yeah, will he go to the 11 or will he stick it on the 21? Ooh. Will he slot the 5? I think it's one of those.
I think the choice is between 5 and 21.
I think so as well.
Stripping the midpoint looks too much.
I agree. Could end up discombobulating yourself in the future.
Yeah. Michi, what do you think?
This 6-2 is too difficult for me, but once I slot on the bar point, then I want to slot on the 4 point.
Okay, that's another option.
Wow, super bold. I love it.
Yeah.
Yeah, unstacking. Yeah. Okay, he goes this way. He's still slightly unsure. Just checking again. Yeah.
He went for 2 down.
He did. Yeah. Okay. Here's the hitter. Yeah.
Hitting
another
easy.
Question.
Yep. This 2 is not easy. Okay.
Yeah, I think it definitely this way. So you're aiming
Stuxen at... Jackson makes the point.
Yeah, but you're aiming at making your 5 points. So I like this move. Okay, and now he's delighted that
2-6 from the ball. Sorry.
Yeah, he's gonna whack on the 5, I would imagine.
Definitely.
Yeah. Better than volunteering without a hit. Aha.
Oh.
2-6, I believe.
Red misses.
No, 1-6.
I think.
1-6, yeah. I think he has to do this. Just make it difficult for the straggler to get away.
Now, white has the advantage.
Big advantage. Yeah.
Aces are duplicated.
Oh, no.
Maybe forced to make the ace point here.
It's a mandatory hit.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the only reasonable choice.
Yeah. Slightly
in case of dance.
Yeah.
Look at this.
What?
He did
what?
That.
What's going to happen?
Well, it must be cube action, I would have thought. Hitting with aces, sixes and fours.
I maybe definitely cube this.
I do as well. While he's slightly got his pants down, I think we take advantage.
Yeah.
White 3 point board against the 1 point board.
Yeah.
10 checkers in the zone.
And yeah,
in the zone and the blot on the midpoint and the blot on the deuce. A lot of reasons to cube.
I think so. I can see a very nice gammon in the future if it goes well. I think if you roll well, you lose your market.
What rolls are losing the market? What do you think?
Well, anything kind of pointing on the deuce or hitting loose and not coming in with an anchor. Even something like a 3-1 or a double one and planning.
And the take.
3-1.
Oh, wow. Look at this. He can make the 5. He can hit.
I made the 5. In a heartbeat, egg. I made the 5. Five.
Yeah.
I think it would be there's the fan.
Now, red is in danger.
Big danger. It would have been the classic overplay for me, slashing on the deuce.
And then another, up.
Yeah, yes. Another great saying from the legend Falafel.
Oh,
he's back.
Oh, he is back. In the game. He's back in the ball game for sure.
Yeah.
Still now big very, favorite.
Very still. Important for Reece to make his bar point.
Yeah.
Almost done.
Yes.
Not enough.
That's right. Just has to swing it round. Aha.
Is that a hit or is too early for the hit?
Wow, very tricky question, isn't it? Yeah.
I think it's too early.
Really?
I'm not sure. I mean, he can tidy everything up now. Tough decision. Very tough.
Red has no board. White has 4-point board. That's why Jörgen didn't hit. But.
Yeah.
You don't like it, Michi?
No. Slotting on the 2-point is not beautiful.
Slotting on the 2-point is very ugly, actually.
Yeah.
But otherwise, there are too many gammons in the air.
Maybe, yeah. So you do hit as well.
Yeah, very tough decision.
So this double three is a wonderful dice. I would come up to the bar point.
I would definitely come up to the bar and challenge the midpoint. Yeah. I think you'll miss that contact point. If you stay back, gives him much easier chances to win the game. You can play a lot more freely.
I'm gonna say this double three is the best dice for red.
Yeah.
So Michi, if you make the bar, do you make the 4-point or do you slot the 4-point as Jörgen did?
Oh wow, it's a difficult part for me. How do you do?
Yeah. Okay, he's getting more ready.
I think I like the way he did.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, he's getting himself ready.
No, White has immediate bad numbers, many bad numbers.
He does also indeed. Sixes. Okay, it looks like a 5-3.
Wow. White can play safely, but...
Yes, that may be a losing strategy. Let's look. No, I don't like this at all. I'm giving the shot here.
Oh, so you leave the midpoint?
Yeah, I think so. If you get missed, it's a wonderful solution to fill in the empty 4-point and sprint yourself or move yourself towards victory in this game.
Yeah, I bought
this
play.
It, Eric. And yeah. Duplicating the trees, obviously.
Yes. I think it was very important for the mid and long term. I think the other way, you were going to be even more massive favorite to leave future shots.
Oh, it's one of the worst entering number.
Yeah, so dumpage or slot the 4? This is the decision.
Uses. I slot the 4.
I slot the 4 as well.
Wow, you are brave guys.
Well, you know, it's having all these grandmasters in the studio, getting the insight into their vision. You begin to see backgammon in a different way, for sure.
Yeah, so actually, I agree with you guys. I just slot on the 4-point.
Yeah.
Oh, you are a brave guy, Michi.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
When it's necessary, right?
Yeah.
Yes, and that's
a good strategy.
Yeah, that's what backgammon's all about. I think you have to play the game without fear and know when to push the button and when to hold off. That's definitely the key to a winning formula for being successful at backgammon.
Maybe it's a small, but I would play to the 11 point. Wow!
Wow! Look at that. That's huge. Bam! He comes in.
Oh, my goodness.
3-5 fan. Wow. Yes, now
well,
I think
gentlemen, let me remind you that those two players are in the undefeated final. That means they are not fanning a lot and they are hitting everything that can be hit.
That's true. Yeah.
Talking about finals, Michi, big congratulations for you and Team Japan for making it to the final. I know it's one position lower than you probably all wanted, but it's still a great achievement. So well done, guys.
Thank you very much. Wow. You are so, it's such a nice word.
Yes.
I appreciate it. Yeah. We do our best. And we have the best team ever.
Yeah, that's I was talking about that a little yesterday. Marvelous effort as well for Team Japan, but that's the beauty and the beast of backgammon. Even if you had world numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 playing in the team, there's no guarantee they're going to be team world champions. Of course, over the length of time, if you've got 10 or 15 years, I'm quite sure they're going to win the event more than once, but in the here and now, not always going to be the case.
Yep.
Wow. Look at this.
Wow,
that's huge.
He feels a gap.
Yes, he does, and that was the problem point. That's been solved, so now can he roll himself forward for the G? 1, 2, yep.
And by a 6 point, which is not too bad.
Yeah. The alternative is leaving a shot, which he's not going to do, of course. 2 and 4.
Now, what is a winning gammon?
Yeah. If he doesn't leave, if he gets missed all the way down the line.
Nine shot leaving numbers, not one of them.
Yeah.
Okay. But so far, quite... does not take any checkers off. Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah, he still can lose a gammon.
Yes.
That's right.
Maybe white might roll double two.
Could do.
Oh!
Oh! Wow.
Wow.
No gammon. For Jörgen. Well done,
Reece. finally, he saved the gammon.
He did indeed. Yeah. Ah, getting more interesting. Jörgen under more pressure.
Okay, a small step from saving the G to the winning the G.
Yeah, okay, there's a small window here, potentially for Jörgen, as Reece has three checkers on his 3 point, so needs to roll something in ace, otherwise he's going to leave a block.
Or double.
Yeah. And
okay.
Here we go. 11 shots.
Shot.
Can he?
Oh my goodness.
He hits.
Oh my goodness.
Wow. Makes it much more exciting. Are we going to see the turnaround?
Now,
potentially, yes.
Who is the favorite now?
Still very.
It's 50-50.
Yeah. I say very slightly
Reece. 8 checkers.
Yeah, very slightly Reece, but. Anything is possible. Let's see. Let's see what he's going to do here. Definitely makes it more interesting. 5-3 to play.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So usually we take care of double 5, double 4.
That's right. Don't want to be hurt by those doubles to ruin our forward position.
Really so, Michi, what does Jörgen need before to redouble?
So, yeah, red have to take some checkers off. So far, white took how many? 2, 4, 8 checkers off. Yeah. So, 4 checkers off is the condition.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. So how long will it take Jörgen before he has to open up? Straight away.
Wow.
Oh, look at
this.
Yeah. More checkers.
Yeah, if white passes, the game will be over.
It's 5 checkers. Oh, there's the hit. Huge roll from Hodges. Hodges from the UK.
They don't dance.
They don't miss. Now we know why they're in this round. And as Falafel would say, now we know why they're there and I'm here. Yes.
You know, I see there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow. Oh, more interesting. That's five checkers off. Five off.
That's impressive.
Yes. Eight off versus five off. Contact.
Staying back.
Yes, very wise.
Just rolling 3-2 and 4-1.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is interesting.
Very interesting. Yeah.
Reece takes now something big, and this is going to be probably the end of the game.
He makes it.
Okay, he hits.
He does.
Not the end of the game yet in this case.
Definitely not.
Five is automatic, and then three is good.
Yeah.
Back as possible.
Any more drama?
Wow.
Yes, look at this.
It's never end.
Yeah. Look at this. More action. Oh. Yeah. Okay. Both of them on top form. Oh, okay.
First pen.
Yeah. I think it's too early. Five off versus eight off. I certainly would not recube here. Give the power of the cube away. Too early. Not in the right quadrant for me.
Coming into the outfield, and then if another fan, it could be well considered.
Absolutely. Okay.
3-5, 3-3, 3-6. Double fours, double fives, double sixes.
Yes. Oh, this is really interesting now.
So it's 10 markets.
Yeah, but it's the power of the cube as well, isn't it? So you really have to work these ones out. What do we do here? What would I do?
All the doubles are efficient for Jörgen. Double deuces, they don't bear off more than two checkers.
Yeah, my instinct is that he should wait. Just because... giving away the power of the cube. Yes, if he rolls.
Michi, help us with that.
Wow.
Michi, help us.
I wanted to double, actually.
I'm not so sure.
Me neither.
Six checkers, eight.
Yeah, because look, even now, he's got nine versus seven.
Okay. And,
four, five.
He's not guaranteed to take off two.
Oh my goodness.
He has a different plan. Yeah. That's the end of that one.
Okay.
Oh, look at the polite the polite cue from world champion Grandsted. Just a little I know you're a young player. I just give it a little touch here of the cube. I think if he was playing Mochi or Michi, that would have been thrust a little bit more across the board.
Yeah. Now I know.
3-1, Jörgen. What a turnaround in this game, ladies and gentlemen.
Amazing turnaround. Yeah. Wow. What a great game that was. Backwards and forwards, changing all the time.
Those two checkers hitting each other 10 times before Reece getting a fan.
Yeah. And
putting two checkers on the board. Yep.
Yeah. And I can confirm that the recube action was a very big no redouble take. Very big.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, so great stuff here. in this undefeated final. Triple world champion, Jörgen Grandsted from Sweden. And thank you to Bojo, has informed me that Reece Hodges is the current online world youth champion. So, two world champions battling it out. The young pretender versus the mighty three-time champion in modern-day history of Jörgen Grandsted. Fabulous stuff.
This 6-1 is interesting.
Yeah, very interesting.
So how do you play, guys?
Yeah, I think I'm slightly more in favor of this one just because it's just not as much on you. And you, as you have the three-point board, you've got an extra cover to maybe make the ace if we're missed. Okay, prefers the contact here. Yeah. So it makes the solid position.
Ooh.
Okay. Yeah.
4 and 3.
I think it is. And I think he's got, I would slot 20 and 21. Yes, it's in the jaws of the lion, but okay, there's also this.
This looks like my preferred play, not getting the gun.
Yeah, actually, that's my play as well.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, this is very inviting for the attack, isn't it?
Yeah, after this play, double tiger might happen.
Yes, I think it's very much so. Yeah, and we have the originator in the house of this wonderful term.
Okay, he went for the... Ooh. Oh, wow, look at
this.
Wow,
huge.
Yeah.
Wow. I would make 3 and 2 points in a heartbeat.
Me as well.
Yep.
That's what Jörgen did as well.
Full house.
Let's
see what Reece does here. In with one.
Beautiful 5-1.
Okay.
Yes.
So
now
I think that prevented the cube.
I think so. I think it's, unless you roll a perfecta, it's a little bit too risque, isn't it? Where if you cube and take, you're going to be forced to maybe smash loose. Mind you, he does have the one on the other side. So he got fours, ones, threes, fives. But he's ahead in the score. That's the only smaller thing to take into consideration.
I think a classic example of dancing two on the bar, two good, one in, one on the bar, double take, and two in, slight not double. That's what I think.
Oh, really? Wow. For me, it looks a double.
Yeah, it might be with the advanced anchor and threats here. Good chances to win gammon.
Could be, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. The problem is that red's sixes are bad.
Yes. Let's have a look. Okay.
Two doubles.
Yeah, I agree with him.
I like it. I like it a lot. And okay, double and take.
Obviously.
Yeah.
Oh, and the sixes came out.
Yes, 6 and 2. I think you just make the 4 point.
I like the 4 point.
I like the 4 point a lot just because of the blot on Reece's ace point and still has the blot on the nine. That puts the power in the position and the check is where you want them to be. Yeah, for me, I would do this for sure. This is the move, in my opinion. Yeah.
Duplicating the force.
Yeah. Ah, yes.
Yeah, nice. Everywhere.
Yes, and...
Triplicating the force, right, Mitty?
Right. Triplicating.
indicating that.
And very well done, Michi. You were massively correct on the doubling position. I can confirm that it's actually a double and quite a reasonable pass. So well done.
Is it pass?
Yeah, very decent sized pass as well. 211 millipoints.
Oh my goodness. I'm shocked.
Oh wow.
Yeah, just because of the gammons.
I am even more shocked.
he's almost got 30%, but just the gammon value, 35% gammons when it goes well.
Yeah. So I completely misevaluated the position then.
Yeah, I was on that same pathway as well. Easily done, but not Grandmaster Michi. He sensed it immediately. Well done. Okay. Yes. And 32. Now, what do we do here? Do we go all in to try and make the five by breaking the mid? I might do that, I think. I think everything else is a bit awkward. And you're going to struggle to make that 5 point. Yes, it's quite a few shots. Double 4, 6-2, 6-3, 6-4, but...
Nine shots.
Yeah, I think it may be worth it. Otherwise, what are you going to play?
Yeah. How about slotting the 5 point? Is it crazy?
8-6, 8-5?
It's not that crazy.
But, yep.
I think I slightly prefer it this way, because if he hits you, you get the free return shot at the ace block.
Just not enough, 6-1.
Ooh. Yes. Yeah. And? Five points.
Now he has an option.
Yeah, only one option for me. I make the power play straight into the 5 point for me. So powerful. Okay, this contains, but...
Yep.
I like the 5 point much more. I think the threat... of that solid 5 point board.
Yeah.
I think the opponent has to tiptoe through the tulips for a long time.
Yeah.
I love this one.
I believe, Eric, you are correct. Yeah.
Especially with the blot on the 24, even if he gets hit, he can hit back and win a gammon.
That's absolutely true.
And in some variations, if he gets missed, he can make a 6 point on the next roll. Sorry, 6 prime on the next roll. So yeah. I'm very much in favor of. Making the 5 point here.
Yeah, I have the same feeling.
I agree with both of you.
Aha, we like.
Yeah, and the difference is not small. That's what I think.
I agree with you. I agree. He's having a good think about this for obvious reasons. Yeah, I like it.
Now.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Look at this.
Is the opposite dice.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, let's see what he's going to do here.
This makes a lot of sense.
It does. Yeah.
Because of the 5 point board.
Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah,
because he's never getting into a situation where he's going to be a favorite in a hitting exchange.
Yes. Yeah. And again. Yeah.
23.
Yeah, I think to have a good think here.
Yeah, ace
maybe
three.
Going from 10 to 5.
I think so. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I like for, 10, 8 to
for
3.
For me, the last checker must stay.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Ah, okay. Prefers it this way. staying further back. Very much so. Oh, look at that. Great time for Lovers League.
Oh, wow. 6-5.
Yeah. Yeah. And confirmed the 5 point was play. No, but on the previous play with the 4-3.
Look at
the only play was making the 5. So well done, Michi.
Oh, actually, I'm wondering why Red didn't slot on the 1 point with a 2.
Yeah, maybe the same kind of, oh, maybe I'm going to get a shot, so I don't want to slot. I do recognize that feeling quite a lot in the backgammon. The future thought, you can talk yourself into other things sometimes.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, and I referenced it earlier. It happens all the time in duets, all the time. No, don't slow. No, we're going to get shot. All the time. And as aforementioned, at least seven out of 10, they never leave the shot. Yeah.
XG says slot, says Martin Hove.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Tough play here.
Yeah, it is.
But Hodges really doesn't want to. I think he's got the right idea. Okay, prefers to keep that one there for the chance to make the stronger 4 point, but creates a bit more or a not so good wastage this way. I expect he's not as concerned. More focus on trying to win the game. What do you play here, guys? Slightly prefer this one.
Yes.
Yeah, just looks a bit more balanced for me.
Yeah, keeping 4 point board seems a must.
Yes. Okay, that's the signal for Jörgen to jump ship. Ah, he sees something else. Ah, yes, the hitting 4. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, definitely a deeper think on this one. I think he's going through a few of the numbers here. Looking at some of the jokers and the super jokers. Okay. Jogs it on.
Wow,
yeah. And lift. Yes, actually not that many shots. Only 3. Oh, sorry, my apologies, 5. But this will definitely help him to clear the point and win the game. Oh, now he's got no choice but to make it.
Yeah.
Yeah, anything else is gives many more shots. Okay, 8s and 9s for Jörgen here. What's he going to do? And there's the 8 with the closed board. He's on man on fire. Okay, yeah. But whatever happens, this is a wonderful insight for Mr. Reece Hodges from the UK to play triple world champion Jörgen Grandsted. It's an invaluable lesson for sure. Win or lose, it'll be much better for the experience. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
So Red has some chance to win gammon.
He does, if it goes well for him. Yeah. Yeah, even better. Oh, look at that. 2 off and K keeping the five board. Oh, great shake from Reece there. Yeah. Strong chances to save G now. Yeah, correct. Two off. Okay. Yeah. And any excitement? Not quite yet. 42. Okay. Slightly limping. He's already thinking about slotting for the double fives, but I don't like any wastage here. Prefer to get into the quadrant or the zone and then think about it from there. Okay, six. Yeah, I think, what does that give you? That gives you extra threes, doesn't it? You've got, yeah. Yeah, it has to be right here. Yeah. Many more numbers take off rather than the invisible double five.
And one, two,
five. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. There it is. There's the save. Yeah. Very interesting game. Yeah.
Okay. Jesper Carlson is asking in the chat if the winner of this match is playing the fighter bracket winner later. That's right, Jesper. The winner of this match is going to qualify for the big final, and he's going to play the bracket final, the bracket winner, on Sunday at 11 o'clock backgammon time or WBGF time. The first match, and if the bracket winner wins the first match, they're going to play a second match at 1:45 backgammon time on Sunday.
Yes. And building up nicely this match. Jörgen Grandsted in the driving seat on the front foot, taking his opportunities, cubing and winning, turning around. Going to be difficult to shake off with his many years of top level experience, but the young pretender in Reece Hodges here is not going to be fazed, as he doesn't know any different in his young shoes. 64, very nice indeed. Has the options. What do we do here, guys? Do we hit or make anchor?
I'd make the anchor.
I would as well. I think as he's got the 4 point made, cube in middle.
Yeah, and red is in at the initial stage, so.
Yes. Tricky, because the natural impulse is to hit as often as possible. Could be right, of course, but the solidity of having the 18 and looking for more chances while Jürgen's not out of the starting blocks on the 24.
And my book says, against the glued back checkers, building is more important than hitting.
Yes. Very nice, Michi. You do have a unique talent to express these things in such a colorful way in imagination and pictures. Very much appreciated your excellent efforts.
Thank you, Eric.
Yourself and Mr. Roland Herrera from the UK, giving us different visions and pictures of backgammon. Very, very nice.
Yeah. Roland Herrera is a wonderful co-author.
He is, and a wonderful player himself. If it wasn't for his work commitments, I'm pretty sure he'd be playing more backgammon tournaments. But very, very high level in classical music from a teaching aspect.
That's correct.
Yep, so you can't do both, unfortunately. If you're going to keep your level at the highest levels, you have to focus on that. That's why we don't see as much as we would like of Mr. Herrera.
So 5-2.
Yeah, very interesting now. Yeah. I like it when they get the fingers going, checking things out. Yeah.
Wow, it's hard for me.
Yeah. Okay, lovely shake there by Reece. Makes the 5 point. Very powerful. 32. Lovely advanced hand cut from Jörgen. 41.
Slotting the 4 doesn't look bad here.
Yeah, has a lot of benefits. Better than, not better, but more effective, keeping everything in front of anchor.
And there is ace duplication as well.
Yes, good point, Bojo. While he's underdeveloped in his home board, might be the chance to take a little bit more risk. You do have the 18 anchor as a little bit of protection as well. So, yeah.
Normally, we don't like slotting when having only one spare checker to cover, one spare number. But I think in this case, because of the ace duplications and the 4 prime, this is worth doing it.
Yes. And okay, he's working a few things out, trying to look into the future and bring it into the present, work out what he's going to do next.
Wow, this 4 is very difficult for me.
I love this one. Whether it's right or wrong, I just like the expression and it feels the right way to do it while he's got the blot mentioned by Bojo before and the duplication. Because that anchor's going to be there for quite some time in the game. And that's the valuable point to give yourself more winning chances, is making that 4 point. And there it is.
Okay.
And I would definitely make it for sure and leave nothing.
Oh, yeah. No, no. What?
Oh, he's got 2 blots in his inner board. Ah, okay. You highlighted that to me, Michi. Thank you. I wasn't paying attention. Thank you.
Well played, Michi.
Grandmaster goggles. Yeah, in full effect, live in session. Yeah. Okay.
Wow.
Okay.
This role is very important.
Hugely important here. Very volatile. Lots of things happening. Oh, is he? I think Reece
is considering to double.
Yeah, they're behind the action cube. Yeah. If he comes in, it's obviously good. Lots of hitting numbers, but can be risque even when behind.
I think even a death score is too early for that.
I agree.
2-4.
Yeah. That's an air ball initially.
Plays itself, I think.
It does indeed. Too powerful. Jürgen's forward position. Can't take the risk at the moment. Oh my god.
Oh my.
Wow.
It's the best dice by far.
Makes the 3.
Unbelievable.
Slots the deuce.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Okay.
Can someone in the hotel get a bucket of water? This man is on fire. Okay, jump out and then think
and
about
look at
ace.
This.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, buttons up. I suppose with the natural shooting number, no need to give the turnaround.
He's hoping for the same roll.
Yeah, as mean as hell, only leaving him double ace from the roof. There it is. He picks it up anyway. Seen the position many, many times. Utilizing his wonderful experience here. There's the closeout.
That's a perfect.
Jörgen is absolutely on fire.
He is. He's going to be a very difficult man to shake off. But as Reece Hodges is a young man, he's not going to be fazed by these kind of scenarios. Doesn't have enough experience yet to know any better. So he's going to be playing for the win, I'm sure. Okay, yeah, just trying best to avoid the anti-jokers. Oh, nearly. Nearly the double force. Manages to avoid that. Second best bear off position. Yeah. Now
is
I wouldn't.
4-1.
Yeah, just off and to the five for me.
6-2, 5-4 for me.
Oh, the safest play.
I like this one. Yeah, I like this
two
one.
On the bar, two on the 18, and four more checkers in the outfield.
Yeah.
It cannot be saved without a hit. So no need to give any extra chances to hit.
I agree. Okay. Yeah. Fan.
So four bad dice.
Yeah. 1-2. That goes back. 1-2, 3.
Off.
Definitely off. It's very
just
likely to come in. Yeah, I would do. Oh, okay. He prefers it picture perfect rather than off. The scenario is he must not come in. He's got to roll a double. He must not come in. He exposes. He hits. That's a very, very big parlay, in my opinion. I would have ripped there for sure.
Okay, so Reece has six rolls to save the G if Jörgen got no double, gets no double.
Yeah, and also because in the play he made, it left him
okay,
odd.
Good beginning.
Yeah. He may regret not ripping that extra check out.
The best start.
Yeah, he's got that pesky odd one. Will that make the difference here? Will he get the undoubled gammon? Will Reece save it? Who knows? Let's wait and see. Yeah. Oh, was there? Oh, just
yeah.
double checking the play.
Yeah, it is illegal.
Okay, well spotted, Michi. Yeah. Accidental, of course. Happens
Look
all the time.
This.
Wow, putting the pressure on here. Grandsted in the zone, seeing the checkers like saucers. Yes.
Don't mess up with me in the race positions, he says.
Absolutely.
Wow, still white can save gammon.
He can, it is.
Double fives, double sixes.
Yes, two numbers here. Will he?
Woo!
Oh, great effort. Great effort.
Almost.
Yes, but Grandsted steaming forward.
Six away, 12 away.
Yeah.
2 points for each one for Jörgen.
That's right. And I do like his game. I haven't seen him play before. Even though he's my countryman, I like the way he moves around the board. Looks comfortable, even though I only see the arms moving. I can sense quite a lot, just seeing minimal parts of the human body. Okay, I jump off the five, or what would be the 20, I feel. Some duplication of the deuces. But I suppose in the other way, you're duplicating the threes. But I think he would much more prefer to make the five over the four.
Is this double because of the score?
Could be, actually. Yeah. Could very well be. Twos, fours, three loose blocks. Why not? I think I may have taken a risk there. Even if it's a little bit gun-shy. Let's see what Jörgen does here. And, wow,
ooh.
Double fives. Look at this. So, I think he's got to put the ace point up on the roof and then think about the final one, just to reduce his chances to make the 4 point. Yeah. Nice move.
What?
Wow. Look at this. Wow.
The hitting?
I don't know. I think it all depends on the race here. He's got many, many different ways he can do it. There's this. He can go all the way to the mid as well. He can hit inside the home board. Wow, many different ways to do this. Okay, yeah.
Ooh, he did it. Play.
He did it. Well done, Reece. And well spotted, Michi. Okay, yeah, on reflection, I think that was definitely the better move. In particular, being behind in the score. Yeah, he needs it to try and get back into the match.
What?
Fan.
Is it the perfect moment to offer a cube?
Definitely, I think you have to now. You've got one back, one almost fully escaped and coming into the picture. And I think if you allow your opponent to see the roll, it makes his decision a lot easier. So I would definitely cube this.
Two buried checkers for Jörgen.
Yes, well spotted, Bojo. This is definitely the moment. You can't wait to for better positions to present themselves. You have to take your chances when they're there. Very nice. And is that 1-3?
So hitting is a must.
Yes, most definitely. And then does he come to the 10 or the 11? The 10 will give coverage on both checkers.
Yep, 10 is much
for me.
Yeah, 10 is better. Yeah.
I'm stacking the midpoint.
Yeah.
Wow.
Very volatile, just what Reece needs. Hoping for the fan. In with one. Okay. And now we see the importance of having the spare on the 10.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
Does he go again? Does he go all in with the... Okay.
No, it doesn't make sense to me.
So you carry on the blitz here, Michi?
Yep.
Yeah, makes sense, doesn't it? Behind in the score. Not the time to button.
He needs to win. Four points, not two.
Yeah, I agree, Bojo. I agree.
Yeah, but maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah, tough to say. You don't have that many checkers in the zone. Score-wise, this is definitely the preferred look-see. But with not enough ammunition where you need it, is it the best way to power home to try and get 4 points or winning the game or the gammon?
Yeah.
That's what you have to look at now.
Yes. Yeah, making the 20 point is looks weak. Oh!
Okay, does it? This gives Jörgen many chances. Is that double two?
Yeah, Jörgen is a killer.
Yes, double ducks. Look at this. Quack, quack. Oh, my.
Oh.
Wow, this man is just unstoppable at the moment. Everything going his way, riding the crest of the wave.
Jörgen showing no mercy, leaving no chances for Reece for the moment.
Definitely, we can see that he's a merciless champion. And for those reasons, we know why he's a triple world champion. Absolutely monstrous in competitive instinct here. Doesn't give his opponent a dicky boat. Okay, slightly more awkward this way. 5-3. I can see he's maybe a little bit reluctant to hit the other one and maybe activate the back game. So he's going through his processes here. Do I make the three? Do I hit and do something else?
Yeah, I would hit outside.
I would hit outside as well. I think that gives you the best way to bring your checkers around. I think you can outthink yourself a little bit the other way. And as the 20 and the 21 point it's not going to be too disappointing if he does make the 21 anchor. Still lots of space to jump over or jump past. Oh, oh wow.
So making the 11 point.
Yeah. Could very well be.
Isn't making the 11 point an island position, Michi?
Mm-hmm. Oh, you are correct.
Yes, Bojo is very good at spotting the island. Yeah. Yeah, very tough play. Very tough.
Wow. This is interesting.
Yeah, it's getting more and more interesting as things move along. Yeah, let's see what he does here.
Reece has his low 1 and 3 points made, so getting into back game is not really his game plan.
Yes, I agree.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, having a good think on this one. Very, very tough play. So many different ways to do things. Can make 11.
7
can...
points is too many.
Yeah.
And one spare checker.
Yes.
Which might easily end up on the bar.
Yes, and I can confirm. Well played, Reece Hodges. Well done, Michi. That is the top play. Is coming in, holding the 23 and 2 to the 11.
Thank you, Eric.
No problem. Yeah. Showing the importance of really understanding more deeply the position.
Yeah, and I definitely make the 4 point.
Yeah, which would be definitely the temptation for a lot of players to make 21. Okay, fair enough. It was only a little bit behind by 48 millipoints, but nonetheless, holding the 23 and being further back with good timing is more important than stepping up.
Yeah, I think 23 very important here because... because of his ace point mate, he would really like to be able to step on his deuce point as well. So holding the 23 looks like the most important part in his strategy now. Maybe more important than the 20.
I agree. Okay, he's changing gears. Just having a look. Yeah. Seeing what his eye sees and feels.
A lot of complicated decisions for Reece this game.
Yeah. Yeah, very much so. Very much so, but that's not such a bad thing. It's going to definitely put garner more experience. Wonderful occasion for him. In the early parts of his young career.
An excellent chance for him to show his qualities.
Most definitely. And I think he's doing that very well. Okay. Jörgen anticipating, visualizing here. Okay. Yeah, he's just having an overview, having a feel for the position here. And he rolls. Wow.
What?
Boom. Double sixes. Okay. One. Two. Make the bar and then think about the final one. Maybe you just bring it down to the bar again and leave the other one there. The other way, can play it safe, but structure, maybe.
I like it very, wow. very much.
I like it.
I'm impressed.
Yeah. Oh, and look at the backgammon intelligence.
Well read timing by Reece. Well played.
Super play. Wasn't even half tempted to hit the loose block there. Recognizing what he needs to do. Get my board ready. Try and hit later when I have a stronger position.
So 9-2-8.
Yes. I like your play, Michi. You cannot play this position stiff. His checkers are going to be there for quite some time. So you must take some risk to improve your forward position and try to come home and win this game.
Here I definitely hit. Yeah. As long as I can save my 23 point.
I agree with you.
Yeah, I agree with you as well, Bojo. And he's in.
Oh, misser.
Yeah.
Not happening often after Jörgen's growth lately.
Yeah, look at this. Jörgen already. Look, he's on about 8-ply here.
8-ply?
Yeah. He's on about 8-ply with this slot move. I love it. Yeah.
I don't see any reason for playing 8-6. This is so, so much better slotting the 4.
Yeah, he prefers to go this way. Make himself tougher to beat. There's the cover. Very nice. 4-point board. Ready for action. That's outfield control. Quadrant control as well.
So double six is anti-joker.
Big anti-joker. Okay, that's actually a very nice shake. Yes, that's where it must go. Leap out of the danger zone, closer to home.
Not coming into direct range with the anchor.
That's right. Okay, nice shake.
But Reece managed to hit.
He did. Yeah, I like his move.
Blocking 6-4.
Yeah, oh! Well spotted, Bojo.
Now
comes the attack if he rolls the hitting number.
What?
No. Is this number?
Wow. Okay, now he has a decision.
16-6 for me.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
No.
I don't think so.
You have to keep that point. You've got a 6-point contact. I think it's that one. You get a lot more control. And you want to keep the contact for longer as you're way behind in race.
This is the play.
I like your play, Bojo.
Because going to the deuce is going to be so counterproductive.
No doubt. No doubt at all. Let's see. Yes, this is my preferred move. And?
Wow.
And, welcome to Grandsted Power.
Oh,
look at this.
It's a fantastic return.
It's a beautiful return hit.
Go to 21, having more
two checkers?
I would have put one there, and I would have gone to 14 with the other one.
Oh, this is not his best.
No. What is it, 3-2? Yeah.
Yeah.
So step up in here. Yeah.
Two six.
Yep. Safety up.
Safety.
Yes.
Now he needs to cover.
He really does.
Wow. It's
still no cover.
Easy.
Outfield control.
So heavy lifting to the 3-point.
Really?
Ooh.
Isn't it too dangerous getting hit?
11 shot. 2-4, 2-5 to cover. Yeah, I think I like it. If he does make it, it does give him so much more in the goal. Wow.
Take this.
It's long distance. That was the radar hit. Long distance.
And now if Reece can hit.
No hit.
Now what's going to happen?
Wow. Yeah. What's the score? He's 7-1 holding a 2-cube. Hardly any bad numbers. Very few bad numbers.
Yeah. Looks like 9-1 to me.
Yeah.
9-1 to me as well.
Oh, I agree with you guys.
Yeah. I think so. There's no too good here because he's anchored. So, yes, I think you have to fire, which he has.
Mm.
Yeah, you can't take this, Reece.
No.
Just too much gets him to two away. You hardly ever get a shot, and if you do, you've got to hit it first time. Otherwise, game over. Just you lose way too many times. At best, you're going to maybe get 1.1 shots, maybe 1.2. And if you miss, you've lost. Too much, I feel, being so far behind in race.
Very unfortunate game for Reece. He faced a lot of difficult decisions. He rolled a bunch of jokers, but Jörgen showed no mercy, coming always back and always getting on the top of it. And finally we ended up with the redouble, which most probably he's going to drop.
No doubt. I like the way he's using his thought processes here, really making sure that he's happy with that. I can understand the temptation being 1-7 down, but this is, for me, is the wrong position to do that in. There's not enough contact, and you just don't see the shot often enough. And even when you do, it's a one-shot wonder. If you don't get it, game over.
Seven numbers don't cover, and one-third of those cases he can hit, and he has the blot on his 4-point. So way under the winning chances he needs in order to take whatever the score is.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And wise decision. Yeah.
So unfortunate game for him. I can imagine the frustration he's feeling at the moment. Although he's not showing it very well covered.
Yes, and I was just
going to have a break.
I tell you what, they must have heard me thinking, because I was just about to say, oh, he's showing a little bit of youthful experience here, not taking a break to try and upset Jürgen's rhythm. But he did eventually, I think, which is good. He's decided to have a break here. Very important in backgammon, knowing when to take your breaks, especially when you're...
I think 7-1 was the latest moment for that, but...
I agree. But nothing bad to the young pretender. Still developing, moving along nicely with his game. Yeah.
Michi, what do you think? Michi, mm-hmm. from strategical point of view, mm-hmm. is it too late now for this break?
I would take a break. Aria, yes.
Okay.
Oh, hello?
Yeah, we're still here. We're still here. Yeah, so, Michi, do you have any more enterprising potential books in the future with your co-author, Roland Herrera? Anything maybe happening?
Yes, of course. I don't want to stop. Yeah. So my next book will be, it's about the doubling cube. And it is specified in a 5-point match.
Wow, yes, this sounds very, very nice. A classical matchup, a 5-point match. All of the backgammon fraternity know this match length very, very well. So I'm sure looking forward to the release of this book. Yes, I think as well, being such a concise match length, you're going to get lots of information and detail in your unique way. So, yeah, really looking forward to that. And what kind of approximate time do you think that will be out for release?
Oh, thank you for asking me about that. It's hard to answer. I'm going to say in October or something.
Oh, so you think before the end of the year, there may be a chance for us to pick up a copy of your lovely book?
Definitely.
Oh, I look forward to that. I really look forward to that. Yes. Yes. And I think we're very fortunate. In modern day times, we're getting lots of lovely work in terms of backgammon book. Sorry, but not backgammon book. My apologies. Backgammon books. I know that we've got before the end of the year, Michi and Roland Herrera's book coming out. I know as well that we have Grandmaster Dirk Schiemann's book that's out at the moment as well. So lots of chances to have a deeper insight into the game of backgammon and reward our marvelous backgammon champions with purchasing the book, rewarding them for their time and effort of studying and putting together these things for us. And I know personally, there's virtually very little return in selling books. It's more for the love of enjoying the process of sharing information and insights, why people do it. You're certainly not going to be retiring on releasing backgammon books. So it would be very, very nice if the backgammon community can really support the efforts of these authors and purchase at least one copy of the book. And if not, or at least doing that, also recommend to other players and people to buy. We must support our authors, support our growth of our game. As we are a minority game, we are growing, we are getting better, but lots more room for us to move ahead for sure. And the way to do that is to support our community in the best way we can. So do look out for those books and purchase. All right. Jörgen Grandsted, triple world champion against the world youth champion here. 9-1 ahead to 13 points. Going to be very difficult for the young man to come back into it against such a legend of the game. But if anyone can, I'm sure he's going to give it his best go. Bojo, any other information about the second chance brackets or any other information about the draw?
Eric, I am not following the other part of the draw. I was very focused on the undefeated, so I will be able to tell you more details a bit later.
Thank you, Bojo. No problem. Always is tricky with so many different rounds and so many different things to keep totally on top of results, etc., etc. But I'm sure the team in Venice are doing the best they can to help the public with having easy access to information. Okay, yes, little break here. Fighting for the right to get through to the final. Sitting in wait. Okay, headphones on, glasses on. Ready to resume very shortly. Here we go. Four away, 12 away. The mighty Grandsted versus the youngling Hodges. Okay, 5-2. Yeah.
Yeah, I like his opening play. Yeah, two men down is my preference.
Yeah, making yourself very tough.
Especially
to beat.
when down in the score.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Double fours. Yeah. And now unstack or, yeah, he's already unstacked. Oh, sorry, unstacked. I think it was that or 16. The two plays.
First play.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yes. Ah, is he eyeballing already? Nope, just...
I don't think so.
I think he was maybe putting a little top on there or doing something. Yeah. Yeah, just checking, making sure he's happy with that.
Oh, I'm sure he isn't.
Yeah, well, he's not happy with the role, that's for sure, but... making the best of something that's slightly awkward. Yeah. Yeah. Obviously, most backgammon players' expectancy is to roll somewhere close to the nuts, but that very rarely happens, of course. And it's the reality that... most numbers are kind of average or just below, and occasionally just above average, very infrequently, super duper.
Oh, by the way, in the previous move, was it possible that the red would leave the anchor with 6-1?
I was also thinking the same thing.
Yeah, me and myself also. Yeah, definitely possible with block behind and gap on four and you holding block on 20 point. Yeah, definitely could have been a consideration. Oh, no, but look at this. He knew that, well, I don't need to leave anchor. I'm going to roll joker and leave anyway. I'm going to give my opponent Eve nothing.
A very nice another exchange of compliments from both players. 4-4 here, 4-4 there.
Yeah. Yeah. And I would give up the midpoint in a heartbeat.
Really?
I like this better.
You really? Do? Yeah.
What?
Another compliment.
What is happening? Who is that?
Boom!
I think now Reece is ahead.
Mm-hmm.
So you like more for the 3-5-3-6 clearing potential, Bojo? Why you prefer it this way?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I was just more assertive, but this way with the slight island. 1-6 may leave a shot. I go the other way. Give myself a bit more time to build inner board. But
Look at this. Another compliment.
what is happening?
I'm not sure, but I tell you what. They're both saying, I'm the better roller. No, I'm better. No, I'm better. No, I'm better.
Double fours, double fours, double sixes, double fives.
Oh my god!
Double threes.
What the hell is this? This is madness.
If this was
online, they'd say the dice are rigged.
Yeah.
Rigged dice party, ladies and gentlemen.
On the
Undefeated final.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they would do.
I'm gonna say I see unreal dice in live backgammon rather than online backgammon.
Yeah, yeah.
I can say it's the same.
Yes, and Reece definitely has the advantage in terms of his bear off position, much more the classical shape, slightly raggedy on the other side for Jörgen, ever so slightly. Did he build her on the two? Gap on tree. Aha. He has other thoughts here. Let's have a little look.
Reece rolled double fours, double sixes, double threes, and five and six, and it was still not good enough for a big cube.
What is this?
I think he's ahead, no?
What is ahead?
Yeah, I think he is.
68 for Reece.
I said White is behind.
No, I think he's actually ahead.
Really?
Yeah.
66 for Jörgen.
And what was Reece?
Yeah, this I forgot.
Ah, okay, no problem.
but still, I believe White was behind in the race.
Or either behind or equal.
Yeah.
So, interesting decision.
Very much so.
Jörgen is very happy with that decision.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Let's have a look. Yeah.
6-2, good row.
Yeah.
He has a very nice distribution now with his last checkers.
He does. Yeah. Let's see.
And here, 6-5 for.
Two off.
4-2.
Yes.
3-0-1 formation. Looks good.
Yeah. Opens it up. Keeps the spread.
Six checkers each.
Yeah, that's off and four. Yeah, fills the gap.
So the question is when red can redouble at this score?
After the end of the game.
Yeah, I would say that as well. Yeah, you don't want to be incentivizing opponent here.
Now red will have a great chance. No, it's not enough.
No way. Can't give a weapon like a four cube here.
Yes! Oh, wow.
Oh, my goodness.
It's a moment.
Yeah, and I noticed a little disappointment there from young Hodges, the little dip of the head.
I sense this anytime if I am Reece.
Oh, for sure. You must. You can't. If he does recube here, you can't pass at the score.
As a normal score.
Far away.
Yeah.
So what is the Reds winning chance here? 80?
Maybe even more than that.
What?
3-1.
But still, it's okay. It's okay.
And 3-2-1 start. 2-1. Okay.
Now the game is over.
And Jörgen roll a 2-1. Okay, no, this is the double pass.
Yeah.
Okay, Michi, you asked when he can redouble. There it is.
All right.
Just before the end of the game.
I got it.
But it was a dead cube, so this is almost considered like after the end of the game.
So now red is two away. White can offer a cube very aggressively.
Yeah, it can. Yeah.
First time there are three blots around, or two blots with a good amount of pointing numbers.
Indeed. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, split and down is a basic in backgammon.
Yeah. And Jörgen has really forged a formidable lead here. It's going to be very, very difficult for young Hodges to win this match, but I'm sure he's going to throw everything in the kitchen sink here at Jörgen to try and ruffle his feathers and get back into this match. Let's see, what can he do? He has the slightly better forward position, hoping to improve and have a window to send the cube over, of course. So let's see what happens. 61 here for Jörgen.
Yeah, 13-7 must be the use of a six.
Yeah, I think so. Oh, has he just got the six to play? He
Yeah,
I think 13-7 as well. Just challenge Reece to do something well, as he doesn't have the best building position. Yeah, I would have slotted the 5 point personally. Yeah.
3-1, good roll.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Okay, why slot the 5 point when I can make 2 points and a prime? Ah, McAlpine, you don't know what you're talking about.
The 5 prime.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Just make and yeah. That's it. And... and doesn't Ooh. Roll his 3. So slot it up. Slot, man. Yes. Oh, yeah, but if he hits me and I've got the blotting board and then this and then this and then that. Slot. Aha.
Yep. Hodges yeah. the stop.
He has. I think he's eyeballing a potential cube here. Will he? Won't he? Yes, he's definitely in thinking mode. Yes, I can tell by his movements here. Yeah. Yeah, he's sensing the opportunity. Will he? Oh, maybe, maybe not. Ah.
He's convincing himself to cube.
Yeah, no doubt.
And actually, he has a problem in time management.
He does.
Well, he does not like the position that much.
That's right. Okay. Yeah, makes the solid four board. And... ah, he's having a, okay. a look now. Yeah. Yeah. What's he got? 26, 59, 61. Yeah, big, big cube, take, I think.
And there is the take.
Yep.
Yeah, his race isn't quite good enough. And no hit for me.
Nope. No hit for me. Yeah.
So we are on the same page.
We are. Yeah. The hymn sheet
probably
is
probably the Jörgen's 4 point board helps us doing that.
Definitely. Makes decision making a lot easier. And this is going to be very tough for Reece now to win this game, even though he's turned the cube. Jörgen does have the racing lead, does have the advanced anchor. So, yes, more to come, I'm sure. Okay, 3-4. I just give up the midpoint personally. No need to fool around when you're going to be leaving their next roll anyway. Just do this and hope to roll your lucky double 3, double 5, double 6. Some stage in the next 3 to 4 rolls. Yeah. And 51. Yeah. There's the lovely 5 board. Nice and powerful. Sending the message to Reece. Take your chances at your own risk. 54. Lovely jubbly. Yeah.
I think 8 pips lead for Jörgen.
Ooh.
Okay. Yeah, so I've seen my play already. I play 5 and ace.
5 and ace.
Making the 10 is the first option that I saw.
This is actually a lot better. I didn't recognize that that was the 0.6 away. This is much better.
Yeah, so giving...
8 numbers.
6? Oh, sorry, you were right, 8.
3, 4, 2, 5, 3, 6, and 4, 5.
Correct. 4-1-4.
And then there is the blot on the ace point, which is not a very big advantage, but it's still considerable.
Yeah, I think he has to because he's behind in race. If he does the other way, it may give an incentive for Jörgen to consider scarpering off the anchor.
I don't like this. He went for that because of the lack of time.
That's right.
Wow!
Wow! And
he was punished because he would have perfectly blocked. Stopped the double sixes.
That's right.
And so, in case White made his 10 point. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, it's one of those that you, on reflection, I really like Bojo's play. You're behind in the race and you're way behind in the score. So, you can't be reluctant to leave some extra shots just based on where you are in the match.
And above all, he was blocking double sixes, four and six. Those big numbers, they bring to a lot of race equity to Jörgen. So it was not just structurally better, but also, okay, look at this, 6-4.
Yes.
Jörgen Monster favorite for a spot in the final.
I think he's 98% or something here minimum, creeping up to 99%.
Yeah,
almost at 100.
Yeah, it must be more than 99.
Yeah, I think so.
101 now.
Oh, over 100.
Wow, I think that's Bojo's factoring in the parlor excellence performance here from Grandmaster Grandsted here.
Okay, yeah. 102.
Yeah, just the kind of performance you're looking for in such an important match here. Fabulous confidence for coming into the final, sitting in wait with two lives. All the others battling it out in second chance. He'll be absolutely brimming with natural confidence. Beating Kritikos in the semis and now the destruction of the young pretender, Reece Hodges.
103% and the winning chances keep rising.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
The game is over.
Okay. It is. Set two and doubles. Match.
Yes, Jordan it is. Yeah. He wants every roll. And there is the handshake.
Hey, congratulations, Jörgen. Well deserved. Good luck in the final.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sure Reece is going to do his best to play Jörgen if possible, two more times on Sunday. Let's see if he's going to succeed on that mission.
Yeah, that's right. He parachutes into the second chance at a much higher level due to his winning prowess in getting through to the undefeated final. He now moves into the second chance bracket and be laying in wait for his next opponent. And Michi, what did you think overall about the matchup here?
Actually, I really recognize that Jörgen is a very strong player. Yeah, he's a good player. Yeah, of course he is. But I really recognize that.
Yes, no doubt. And Bojo, what did you think about the match?
It was a one-horse race, obviously, but still some really exciting games. I believe that both players played really well. Here and there some errors, but overall, I think the level of backgammon was really high in this final. Reece Hodges rolled very well, actually. He got a lot of good numbers, a lot of jokers, but this was way not enough against the machine that Jörgen is at the moment. So, yeah, I'm sure that Reece can be happy with that match and with his play, but under those circumstances and with this super high level player rolling that well, there was no chance for him. So let's see if Jörgen can keep his form for 2 days while he's not playing. He has now time to go and explore the most beautiful city in the world. And I'm sure that he will be ready to continue his winning march on Sunday at 11 o'clock backgammon time.
Hear, hear. I'm quite sure he'll be delighted. He has so much natural experience of playing in so many finals and being successful. I'm sure he'll embrace the 2 days, have a look at Venice. If he's there with his beautiful wife, Mrs. Grandsted, I'm sure they're going to have some nice moments together and really savour being in this individual championship final. And yes, I'm quite sure he'll have a little walk around and see who may be getting through to challenge him for the right to be WBGF individual champion. Yes, but I think he'll actually enjoy that, having a couple of days off. He's got more than enough experience. And yeah, all to come on Sunday. Any other announcements or any other information before we sign off here, Bojo?
The only thing I can say is that we are meeting again at 9 o'clock backgammon time, which is in 2 hours and 20 minutes. And in the meantime, we are going to announce on all the Facebook pages and on YouTube which match we are going to stream.
Okay, thank you very much for that, Bojo. Congratulations to Jörgen Grandsted from Sweden, making it through to the main individual final of the individual. Commiserations to young Reece Hodges. Fabulous effort in such a strength of the field draw to get through to the undefeated final. Still has great possibilities to make it to the main final via the second chance. We will be back with you later for another match. A big, big thank you to our special guest, Grandmaster Michihito Kageyama from Japan.
Yep.
The double tiger, also known as Michi.
I like my new name, Mr. Double Tiger. Ooh.
Oh, yeah. We can't. You are the originator of this wonderful term that without it, backgammon just wouldn't be the same. It's almost one of the terms of backgammon ever, I feel. It's such a wonderful way to express, and we love your addition to backgammon, not only with your high-level sportsmanship and your high level of fair play and etiquette, but also your authoring of the books and giving us this wonderful term, Double Tiger. We love it. Okay.
If I may add, Eric,
of course,
everyone can be a single tiger, but there is only one double tiger.
Oh, very nice, Bojo. It just keeps coming. All right. That's all from us. We love having you here with us, enjoying the backgammon. Do join us later for some more backgammon action. Until then, enjoy the rest of your day. And... ciao, Bella!